everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We are just about set to put the ball on the tee. Everybody get loose and get set for action from the Big 12. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Championship. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Oklahoma has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. Gilmore takes it from the six. And down he goes at the 37. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Gives it up the gut. He makes it to the 38-yard line. Gilmore is looking to get in the record books in this one. He's a very special player, and he really deserves all the praise and awards he could get. Big game for this guy. From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. He's at midfield. Makes it to the 44.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. From the 41-yard line, second down. He fights forward to about the 40. Incomplete.
You can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. They come out in a five-wide set. Going deep. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
They don't pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He makes it to the 42-yard line. Throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He gets rid of this one. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Beach to punt. They'll bring him down at the 36. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
Well, the defensive backs completely jumped the run. Only the run was never there. It was just that misstep that allowed the completion.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. He's at the 40. To the 20. Brought down right around the 12-yard line. Big game there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big game.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Over the middle to his tailback. And he stopped behind the line. Loss of a yard.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
From the 13-yard line, second down. And down he goes, around the 2-yard line. Made around the 1-yard line. It's second and goal. Ball on the 1. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. A 6-play, 64-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 7-0. From the 7. Oh, he got nailed on that one. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. The 10. Touchdown. Big play. The extra point to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. Oh, what a hit. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
Here we go! Man in the air!
And he he's tackled
around the 38-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. And they finally tackle him at the 33. That makes it first and 10. From the 33-yard line, it's first down. There's a strike complete. He's taken down at the 27. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
He's tackled right around the 16-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
So at the end of one, we get a tie game at 7-7. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That makes it second and six.
From the 12-yard line, second down. Goes to the receiver, incomplete.
Horn was the intended receiver on the runway. That'll bring up third and six.
He's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 11. They'll be short of the first down after that unsuccessful running play.
Nice job here by the defense of holding firm and forcing a fourth down.
So it's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal. And this is nothing more than a chip shot. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Adam takes from the 10. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Tackle around the 45-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Three down. Mike 56. Check.
Yellow three.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Gain of 6 yards.
Yardage on that run.
That's good for the Eagles. That makes it first and 10.
Red 2.
Kill.
Blue 4.
After
2.
Blue 4.
He's on the run. And he's taken down at the 30-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Yellow 3.
tackles him hard at the 30.
I think the corner is the toughest position to play in football. You have to be athletic enough to be able to run with wide receivers and willing to be able to come up and make plays like this to be able to stop the run. This is a big-time play by a corner, showing the versatility to be able to come up and be physical in the run game.
And he is drilled at the 33-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. To go, and that one's fallen incomplete. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. It out. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line, first down. Scrambling, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
It's our time. It's our time.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. Very good tackle in space.
That makes it third and three.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. That's a great tackle at the 37-yard line. The 37-yard line. First down. Makes it out to about the 23. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Going to try and scramble. He gets sacked on the play. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Caught with room to work. What a play, and that is first and goal. Five wide. Tries to buy some time. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 78-yard drive. They put up 7 points. The score now, 17-7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Adams takes it from the 6. He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 33. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 33. He steps out at about the 37-yard line. Snap. Oh man, did he take a hit?
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Brought down at the 44-yard line. To that quickly, and he shoved out of bounds around the 42-yard line. We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 17-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively. How about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, then a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirkhurst Street.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He makes it to the 25-yard line. I tell you what, you got to give these guys credit. They put up a great defensive effort in the first half. They carry it over in the second half. Doesn't look like they're going to give in.
Yeah, and this game isn't over yet. I think it's going to require them to continue to play with this kind of edge and attitude to be able to give themselves a chance to win the game, because we still have a ball game in our hands and still a whole quarter to go.
Quick throw. And he's level at the 29. He's out of bounds at the 31.
He scrambles. He's to the 40. Tackle made at the 45. Field and down he goes right around the 50.
That brings him second and five.
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Bolden is the deep man awaiting the return. Brought down at the 21.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're headed in the right direction.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. A two-yard run by the halfback.
Here, the receiver needs to do a better job of holding his block on the corner, or there's no place for the ball carrier to go.
Second and nine coming up here. Ball on their own 23. Pass complete and taken down immediately. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 35. Gilmore takes it up the middle. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds around the 43-yard line. Stone awaits the snap. It's a short kick. Gilmore's game is kind of old school, Kirk.
I love these old school guys. I mean, in this day and age, everybody wants to try to get people out in space. This is a young man that doesn't mind running over top of people.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it.
If they're
going
to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Catches it, and that's all. He laterals. And he hits him hard at the 40-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
Quick strike to the receiver. He's taken down at the 31-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
Defense wins championships, baby.
It's not over yet, folks. We head to the fourth quarter.
17-7.
This very pivotal fourth quarter.
Tight right.
Three down. Mike 56.
Green.
Has some daylight. And he's tackled
around the 11-yard line. That's a good play. First down.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A six-play, 64-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 17-14. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. He's tackled at the 50-yard line. First down. He fires. He's hit and taken down. First and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Here's a running play. He fights forward to about the 23. Six-yard line. From the 26-yard line, third down. Nice catch, first down, he's knocked out.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
Hey,
breaks a tackle, and he'll score. Touchdown. So a six-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you're going to move the ball down the field.
Palmer has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Adam from the five, and he's taken down at the 32. You know, we love being around this defensive coordinator, and he had a plan, and boy, he executed it today.
Yeah, he shared that plan with us, and you wonder sometimes if the plan's going to be able to play out the way it has today. But everything is clicking, from the coaching to the playing and the execution. Just a dominant game.
Just under three to go in regulation. On the ground, up the middle. And they make the stop right around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Time right, time right.
Two down. White 56.
Yellow,
white
4.
56.
Yellow, 3.
Motion.
Yellow, 9.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And they'll get him in the backfield. Taking back a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
They'll bring him down around the 44-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 44. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. Set up and he drops it. And again, they're going for it on fourth down. Just over a minute left. Quick pass, intercepted. Tackle at the 43-yard line. From the 43-yard line, first down. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
And that was the freshman linebacker who was right there to make the play.
He gets to about the 27-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 27. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Around 5 yards on the delayed handoff. The Sooners using their third and final timeout. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. line up the middle. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, the Unicorns, 24, the Sooners, 14. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
You know, I think it was a well-played game for the most part. Oklahoma probably feels they should have won this game, but they just didn't make enough big plays when they needed to.
Oklahoma, they lose this one late in the season, and it gives them a 9-4 record.